Please rise. Dearly beloved, we have gathered here in the sight of God and in the presence of this company to unite Wesley and Magnolia in holy matrimony. Marriage was ordained by God in Eden, confirmed in Cana of Galilee by the presence of our Lord, and is declared by the Apostle Paul to be honorable among all men. Who gives this woman to be married to this man? Would you remain standing as we begin with a word of prayer this afternoon? Jesus, you said that where two or more are gathered in your name, that you are in the midst of them. Today we have gathered in your name to witness this covenant exchange between Wesley and Magnolia. We recognize your presence in the midst of us today and in every aspect of this ceremony. May it all be blessed. Amen. You may be seated. This moment is a gift from God. It's holy and spiritual, and then a kind of mystery. As we witness the covenant exchange between these two, Wesley and Magnolia, today, we also witness the relationship of Christ and his church. The covenant faithfulness and love of God is on full display in our midst here today. And you made it. You did it. All the planning, the preparation, it's done. You're here. And you both arrive here today having lived two lives, telling two separate stories. I have to say that it has been pure joy to watch you both grow up here in the church, along with like half of the bridal party. It really has been a pure joy. I remember when you first started dating, Megan and I were talking and we thought, ah, now that's a great couple. You guys just make sense. I really believe that. And while there was a day in which your two stories intertwined, you started flirting and talking and dating, and then you met each other's families and you know, you began to do life together. Today, your stories don't just intertwine. Your two stories become one story. Your two separate lives become one shared life. In fact, Wesley, today your dad posted on Facebook this morning that the gospel reading for today from the lectionary for daily reading included Matthew 19, 5 and 6, which is so appropriate for today, in which Jesus says, "Therefore a man shall leave his father and mother and hold fast to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. They shall no longer be two, but one flesh. And what therefore God has joined together, let no one separate." Amen? Amen. I know both of you are here today because of your love for one another. And today is about love, and in a world in which trends come and go at the blink of an eye, it's your marriage covenant that is going to sustain your love for the rest of your life. your public exchange of vows and constant wearing of the rings, which represent that exchange of vows, will serve to you as a reminder that your commitment today is a commitment in love, but it also is a commitment to love. And love is a big word. It's the thing that changes everything. It's what binds you together, but it can be hard to define. Every definition of love seems to come short, fall short of what we all experience love truly is. We've all been loved. We've all felt unloved. We've both given love, received love, but the question still remains, what is love? We can try to define it, but instead of defining it, rather, we find it best to describe what love looks like, to describe how love acts and what kind of things love brings into our lives. And so that's what the Apostle Paul does, right, in his most famous wedding passage, 1 Corinthians 13. He says this about love. Love suffers long and is kind. Love does not envy. Love does not parade itself. It's not puffed up. Love does not behave rudely, does not seek its own, and is not provoked. Love thinks no evil, does not rejoice in iniquity, but rejoices in the truth. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never fails. And it is love, the love that does not fail. It's the love that endures. It's the very love that saves the world that will carry you through this life together. My hope for you both, from the depths of my heart, honestly, is that you would find what Jesus said he came to bring, and that is life. Life abundantly, life to the fullest. And I believe that to live, to really live life to the fullest, life abundantly, what life is really meant to be, is to find love. Not just to find love, but to actually walk in love, to express love, to give love. So that we could say this, that to live is to love. And I believe that as we look at the example of Christ, to love is to give, right? For God so loved the world that he gave. Jesus says it is better to give than to receive. In John 15, Jesus says, "This is my command, that you love one another as I have loved you. Greater love has no one than this, that someone give his life for his friends." So remember, if you don't remember anything about what I say today, which will be totally fine, remember this. To live is to love, and to love is to give. Following the perfect picture of the love that we found in Jesus, give yourselves in love for one another always. I have two charges this afternoon. First, to the family and friends of Wesley and Magnolia. Get behind this marriage. Bless them, help them. Fulfill the words of Jesus and do unto them as you would have done unto you. Marriage is a blessing as it is, but so much more so when those who love you and are closest to you are supporting you. And now for you, Wesley and Magnolia. First, Wesley, love your wife like Christ loves the church. Lay down your life for her. Lead the way in love and give all you can to her and for her. And Magnolia, I have to say, Maggie, <It's okay. laughs> honor your husband, prefer him and cherish him. Give all you can to him and for him. If both of you constantly give to one another, you will find that neither of you will be in need. Carry this love, which never fails, into your marriage. Make it your own, and I believe your marriage will never fail. Now, Wesley and Maggie are going to both light the unity candle and receive communion. The unity candle signifying their two lives becoming one shared life. And the receiving of communion this afternoon in recognition of Christ's very presence not only at the center of our gathering today, but in their marriage and in their lives for the rest of their lives. As they light the unity candle, may the love which brings them together become a light which shines in the darkness of our world. May their shared life become a place of warmth and comfort, of hospitality and grace, a sign of the goodness of God shining bright in the land of the living. Amen.
Tomorrow morning, if you wake up and the sun does not appear, I will be here. If in the dark we lose sight of love, hold my hand and have no fear.
Work a lot harder on your marriage than we did on this candle. But let it be a reminder to protect that flame. Don't let it become extinguished. Still going. That's right. You might say that sometimes. Well, what matters is that it keeps going. All right. I'd like to speak a prayer of blessing over you before we exchange vows and rings this afternoon. Eternal God, creator and preserver of all life, author of salvation and giver of all grace, look with favor upon the world you have made and for which your Son gave his life and especially upon this man and this woman, whom you make one flesh in holy matrimony. Give them wisdom and devotion in the ordering of their common life, that each may be to the other a strength in need, a counselor in perplexity, a comfort in sorrow, and a companion in joy. Grant that their wills may be so knit together in your will, and their spirits in your spirit, that they may grow in love and peace with you and one another all the days of their life. Give them grace when they hurt each other to recognize and acknowledge their fault, and to seek each other's forgiveness and yours. Give them such fulfillment of their mutual affection that they may reach out in love and concern for others. Grant that all married persons who witness these vows today may find their lives strengthened and their loyalties confirmed. And, O God, you have so consecrated the covenant of marriage that in it is represented the unity between Christ and his church. Send therefore your blessing upon these your servants, that they may so love, honor, and cherish each other in faithfulness and patience, in wisdom and true godliness, that their home may be a haven of blessing and peace. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Wesley and Magnolia, out of all the individuals that span God's entire world, you have chosen one another. It's now time for the two of you, in the presence of God and this company, to declare with these vows your love for one another and sincere desire to live your lives together. And in exchanging these rings, also as a sign and symbol of this unending love, in doing so, you are entering the covenant of holy matrimony. The rings. Thank you, Alex. Wesley, do you take this woman to be your wedded wife, to live together in the covenant of marriage, to love her, comfort her, honor and keep her, in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live?
I do.
And taking this ring and placing it upon her hand, repeat after me. With this ring,
with this ring,
I thee wed,
I thee wed,
and pledge my life and love to you,
and pledge my life and love to you,
for better or for worse,
for better or for worse,
for richer or poorer,
for richer or poorer,
in sickness and in health,
in sickness and in health,
to love and to cherish,
to love and to cherish,
for as long as we both shall live,
for as long as we both shall live,
in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Magnolia, do you take this man to be your wedded husband, to live together in the covenant of marriage, to love him, comfort him, honor and keep him, in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live?
I do.
And placing this ring upon his hand, please repeat after me. With this ring,
with this ring,
I thee wed.
I thee
and pledge my life and love to you.
And pledge my life and love to you.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or poorer.
For richer or poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
For as long as we both shall live.
For as long as we both shall live.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Because Wesley and Magnolia have desired each other in marriage and have witnessed this before God and our gathering, affirming their acceptance of the responsibilities of such a union, and have pledged their love and faith to each other, sealing their vows in the giving and receiving of rings, I now, by the authority vested in me as a minister of the gospel, pronounce you husband and wife in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Wesley, you may kiss your bride. Thank you. Family and friends, it is now my pleasure to present to you for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Wesley and Magnolia Vreeland. Wesley and Magnolia would like me to thank you for coming this afternoon to their wedding ceremony. They would also like to invite you to a send-off right now. Now, this is peculiar because it's a send-off, but they're coming back. But they wanted to go ahead and do the send-off for those of you who aren't staying for the reception to participate in that. So in just a moment, I'm going to dismiss you. But as you do, going out the back doors, head to the left, and we're going to meet at the front doors of the church for the send-off. But then we'd like to invite you to come back into this room and participate in the reception. They wanted to just let you know that all the important stuff in the reception will happen up front in the very beginning. So if you don't have all day to stay here, they would love for you to come and participate in the beginning of that reception. And as you go outside, we just want to remind you to try and maintain social distancing for everyone's safety this afternoon. Thank you very much for coming today. God bless you. Go in peace. It's a long way down, it's so high off the ground. Sending for an angel to break me apart. Girl, where did you come from? Got me so undone. Gazing your eyes, got me saying, what a beautiful lady. No ifs, ands, or maybes. Releasing my heart and it's feeling amazing. There's no one else that matters, you love me. And I won't let you fall, girl.
Pretending that I'm I'm the great pretender. Adrift in a world of my own. I play the game, but to my real shame, you've left me to dream all alone. Conceal. Oh, yes, I'm the great pretender. Just laughing and gay like a clown. I seem to be, but I'm not. You see, I'm wearing my heart like a crown. Still around. Too real is this feeling of make-believe. Too real when I feel what my heart can't conceal. Yes, I'm the great pretender. Just laughing and gay like a clown. Like a crown, pretending that you're still around.
Still
unforgettable, that's what you are. Unforgettable, though near or far, like a song of love that clings to me. How the thought of you does things to me. Never before has someone been more unforgettable.